My millennial daughter Elizabeth is here with me today, and you know, she got up pretty early. Although she did not water the tree leaving the house. I know.
So now called her out. No.
So now I got to figure out, what am I going to do? Do I go back? You know, like, do I leave here at 10 and then go water it and then come back out? I'm not sure. I don't have to think about that. This tree, I'll tell you. And I'm a big advocate of the natural tree. Yeah. But, you know, it's kind of a lot of work. Honestly, it's kind of a lot of work. And so in millennial fashion, it's my fault because I didn't send her a text reminding her.
How was I supposed to know?
Well, because the tree is in the house.
Yeah, but like, I was up early this morning.
I know. So to a millennial, early is like, what, 7 o'clock? 8 o'clock?
8.
8 o'clock.
That's early.
Okay.
I don't know. Jill told me her kids may still be sleeping, so I don't know if she wanted to call them out. Yeah. So, all right, look. So now I got to figure out the whole tree watering thing. But anyway, Elizabeth, it's good to have you here this early. I know, like 9:15, I think, is early for
it's the record
most,
for this break.
Right. For college break, this is right.
Yeah.
It's almost the middle of the night. All right. So we were talking about re-gifting. Then I got sidetracked. My daughter is back from London, and she joined me in the studio today. And I'll tell you, Bob. So I asked her to water the tree. Right. I thought I asked her to water the tree. But she basically said she didn't water the tree, but it's my fault because I didn't send her a text saying, hey, can you water the tree?
Well, I got to come to her defense. I mean, at this point of the season, the tree's what, been up about three weeks at least? You've had the tree up?
Now, my tree, maybe only two, because remember, I was late this year.
All right, well,
because I waited for her to get back from London. Another thing, right?
According to my good friend Heloise, the hints from Heloise collection.
All right, what does she say?
She says after a certain amount of weeks, the tree stops taking water.
So you're saying it's possible.
It's possible
that the tree's not even taking any water.
That she didn't do any more damage to the tree by not watering it. It's not going to die any sooner because it's already dead, and it's not going to take any water. And
all right,
you've
Bob,
basically
that's
got a match head.
It's a fair. It's a fair assessment,
regardless of her.
See, the challenge being in my family is that it's all fodder for the radio. Like, it could easily come out on the air.
Oh, absolutely.
And they understand.
She's
that
fearful
now
of that.
Well, I don't blame her. Now, my wife, I told you, she'll go into a room and sometimes she will give a general disclaimer.
Not for air?
So just so everybody, no, to the people there saying, you don't know what he's going to talk about.
Have
so
no control
just
over this?
Just know that you could be a story.
So there's no filter in your house?
There's no filter. And it's all there. So, with the tree, I was more harping on the idea that it was my fault because I didn't send the text. See, I look at it this way. Like, you see the tree. You should be thinking as you walk by the tree, maybe the tree needs water.
But kids, they think differently than we do.
Well,
and
that's true.
And it's our own fault that we think that they should think like we do, right? Even though we've raised them to think like we do.
Right.
And we get disappointed when they don't think like we do.
Well, here's the demarcation line. Like, I think once you're launched and you're out of the house, you're an adult.
Yeah, that's good.
Right?
Right.
But I guess, if I had a house guest, they wouldn't necessarily go by the tree and water. Like, I wouldn't
probably
water somebody
not
else's tree.
No. Unless you put a note there.
Right? Unless you put a note. Would you please water my tree?